If I want to teach sustainable techniques, I have to teach myself, first of all. And that's what I did in these 50 years. I'm 52 now. So I think that I would consider myself a continuous learning person.
Ah, it's trolley.
No trolley. And convert it, transform it into a tool, an agricultural tool. I've been lucky because I've been able to be raised in a family still connected with the earth and with the agricultural techniques and with the building, the old building techniques. My family is a family of stonemasons, but we were also growing part of our food. We had animals. I mean, I have a good basic knowledge. I will be able to survive in a sort of a Robinson Crusoe scheme. Even the word machine brings you the idea of a very sophisticated, technologically complicated thing. But this is a machine, this is a simple machine. It's made with recycled material, with wood from our local carpenter, recycled iron. And you make a form with wood, and you begin to put these different layers, and you just press them.
Yeah.
That's the word. Washing machine, and we are going to use it for another project. This will be part of a windmill. So, because not only the motor, but we have also the... All right, this is a stove that we built using recycled material. So first of all, we have a huge fire extinguisher tank. We cut it. We made a double wall door. And we put another small tank inside. And both are connected by a soldering. So the hot fumes that comes from below travels within these two walls. You can cook your pizza, you can cook meat, you can heat water, and because there is a lot of radiant surface, heats very, very well. It's interesting. You have a pizza in 15 minutes. This is to copy statues. We have the original here, and we can copy a statue. This is built with old windows. And we are able to do a very detailed copy. So this is the result of the machine that we saw before. This is the original, and these points are measures that we take from the original and we transfer to the block of a stone. And we are able to either make an exact copy or to decide that we want more breast, for example, in this case. And instead of going to the right, to the spot, you can not only copy exactly, but you can make modifications on the design. So in fact, this is the original 3D printer. As using some joints as loose hairs. See here? So we do it like this. Greek mosaic, just with three colors. We have brown, we have white, and another white which tries to emulate the colors of the water. I mean, the calcium of our body, our bones, is the same calcium that you will find in a limestone.
So limestone, sandstone, earth, wood, and vegetable fibers are materials that are with us since Paleolithic times. There is a deep connection, and once you begin to work with them, your body reacts and sort of remember that connection. I think we are gone a little bit too sophisticated, and we have to return. There is a return to simplicity. For example, these vaults are is an available technology since Gothic period, even Romanesque period. We are a specialist in the techniques of vaulting, making vaults, making domes and arches. And this is very, very, we enjoy a lot to do this because it's reconnecting with our forefathers. It's an old Majorcan tradition, working with this material. And also the possibility of, with something old, doing innovation, making innovation. The materials that have the lowest ecological footprint of all building materials. And it looks gorgeous, it's for me. And this other vault is a Byzantine vault, which you can build without centering, without a wooden structure that holds while you are working. We are not in the middle of a crisis, and we are just at the end of a process that steals the work from the people, and it brings that takes the work from the people, because this work is done by machines. So 100 years ago you needed 100 persons to run a farm. Now you need two machines, and 98 persons will be jobless. So this is the real drama that nobody speaks about, that technology makes people unnecessary.